going to study our lesson number 1. Food. Where does it come from? Okay, now tell me, what is mean by food? Food means the edible substances which we eat for what? To obtain energy or materials required for the growth and development of the body and repair worn out tissues. That is known as food. The substances that we eat, that is known as food. Okay, then what do we mean edible substances? Edible substances means the substances that we can eat. In some cases, different parts like fruits, leaves, stem, roots, underground sound, stem and so on are edible. First, we will think about the fruits, the parts, fruits which are edible like tomato, apple, brinjal, etc. The fruits can be edible. And in the case of mint, spinach, etc., its leaves are edible. And next, in the case of sugarcane, spinach, etc., its stems are edible. And roots of carrot, radish and are edible. And in the case of potato and ginger, its underground stem are edible. Okay, now in the case of some other plants, more than one part is edible, like drumstick. Which part of the drumstick plant is edible? Its leaves are edible, fruit is edible and also flowers are edible. So there are some plants whose more than one part is edible. Okay, next we will see what are the functions of food. Why we are eating food? Okay, see the first one. Why we are eating food? It gives us energy to work and play. So to do any of the activity, suppose we want to play, jump, run, any of these activities can be possible because of the food we are eating, the energy that we are getting from the food. The second one, it keeps our body warm and it helps in the growth of our body. So day by day, in the case of children, their height is increasing, weight is increasing and so on. So the growth of the body is due to the food that we are eating. And the next point, food helps in healing injuries. Suppose we are getting some wound. To heal that injury, we have to take food. And it protects our body from diseases and keep us healthy. So these are the different functions of food. Okay, next we will see what are the sources of food or from where we are getting food. First we see we get food from both plants and animals. Both plants and animals provides us food. So which are the food items that we are getting from plant? The food items such as fruits, vegetables, pulses, etc. we are getting from plants. And which are the food items we are getting from animals? We are getting egg, meat, milk, etc. from animals. And some of the food items can be made by using milk. They are known as milk products. The food items which are making by using milk, that is known as milk products. And the examples are butter, cheese, ghee, paneer, cream, etc. are the examples of milk products. Okay, next we will see what is ingredients. Ingredients means the materials that are needed to prepare a particular type of dish. Why we are adding ingredients to the food items? To increase the taste of the food. When we are adding ingredients, it increases the taste of the food. And some of the ingredients are must to prepare that particular type of dish. For example, in the case of idli, which are the ingredients needed? Raw rice, urad dal, water, salt, etc. And in the case of appam, raw rice, coconut, salt, oil and water are necessary. So, the materials or the food items which are used to make a particular type of dish, that is known as ingredient. Okay, next, importance of cooking. Some of the food items we can eat in their raw form. What do you mean by raw form? Raw form means without cooking it. Some of the food items like a carrot, cucumber, fruits, all these can be eaten in their raw form. But some other food items we have to eat after cooking it. Then why we are cooking food, or what is the importance of cooking? See, the first point, it kills the harmful germs and make it germless. Some food items contain some germs that we cannot see. But while cooking, what happens? Cooking kills the harmful germs present in the food items and make the food item germ-free. So it is safe for us to eat. Okay, next. Cooked food can be easily digested and absorbed by the body. So after cooking, the food becomes soft and it can be easily break down into its similar substances. That means its digestion is easy after cooking it, and the digested food can be easily absorbed by the body, because we need nutrients what is present in the food item. So we have to cook the food. The cooking, next point, food become taste. So cooking increases the taste of the food. That's why we are cooking most of the food items. And next, it can be easily absorbed by the body. So all these are the importance of cooking, or why we are cooking food. Okay, next we will see the classification of animals based on their eating habits. Okay, all animals, they are eating different types of food items. Animals are eating different types of food. So based on the type of food they are eating, we can group them into 5 main groups. See, the first one, herbivores. Herbivores means what? The animals which eat only plant products. They are known as herbivores. And the examples are cow and goat. Okay, next category is carnivores. Carnivores means what? The animals that eat the flesh of other animals are known as carnivores. And the examples are lion, tiger, etc. Okay, and the third category is omnivores. The animals which eat both the flesh of other animals and also the plants, both, they are known as omnivores. And the examples are bear and we, the human beings, they are also omnivores. Okay, these two categories, the next two categories are due to, okay, you are not studied about it. So parasites. Parasites means the animals which sucks blood from other animals, like mosquitoes, lice, bed bug, etc. They are sucking blood from other animals. They are known as parasites. And the last category is scavengers, which feed on dead and leaking matter and helps us to clean our surroundings. That's why they are known as scavengers. Okay, and the examples are crow and vulture. So, based on the food they are eating, animals are grouped into 5 different categories: carnivores, herbivores, omnivores, parasites and scavengers. Okay, we will study about rearing of animals. What do you mean by rearing of animals? To get food or other purpose, to yield money, we are rearing some of the animals. So the particular name given to that we are going to discuss now. So the rearing of honeybees, for that to obtain honey, it is known as apiculture, and the rearing of silkworms to obtain silk, it is known as sericulture, and the rearing of fish in a large scale is known as pisciculture, and the rearing of birds is known as poultry. These are the special names given to the rearing of animals. Okay, once again we will start revise what all are the things we have studied in this chapter. First we studied about food. The substances that we are eating are known as food. And next is about edible substances. The substances that can be eaten are called edible substances, and in the case of some plants, its leaves are edible. In other case, cases, its fruits are edible, and in some other cases, more than one part of the plants are edible. Okay, next is about sources of food. So we get food from both plants and animals. And so next about milk products. The food items which are making by using milk, they are known as milk products. And next is about ingredients. What do you mean by ingredients? The food items that are using to make a particular type of dish, that is known as ingredient. Okay, next is about the importance of cooking. We have seen 5-6 points about the importance of cooking, or what happens to the food while cooking, how it helps us. And next is about the classification of animals based on their eating habits. Okay, you can group the animals into 5 different groups based on their eating habits. Okay, next is about rearing of animals. The special names given to the rearing of animals. Okay, thank you, children.